Hi guys, welcome to the second part of our in-depth tutorial where we explain how to deal with a video that went through the in-cam noise reduction and aggressive video codec. In the previous video, we explained the specific issues you may have at the profiling stage. Now let's talk about filter settings. Here, in Adjust and Preview tab, we can see denoised results and we can adjust filter settings if necessary. Let's start with our standard procedure. Go through the steps of filter settings check. Do noise level check. The blue mask should cover areas with no movement. This looks nice. Then go to the local flicker check. Flicker is a dynamic effect, so it is best to check it using playback. Bring the slider up until the blue mask covers pretty much everything that is not moving. This should be enough. Now, it's turn of the repeated frame check. This mode highlights the bits of repeated noise if they are present in the video. Stop playback. It's easier to see the repeated noise this way. Zoom in. And it seems we don't have much of repeated noise, just some tiny bits. I'll try increasing the radius slightly, as it might be enough. I'm setting it to 3, and it does give me what I was after. Look at this line, and I'll show you what happens when I change the radius back to 2. And then to 3. There is a subtle difference, but it will give a better overall picture. And we don't have to adjust the repeated frame slider at all, which is great as we'll preserve more details this way. Click Finish. Now let's see the results in playback. I don't really see any noise left, so I don't think we need to tweak spatial filter. However, there is still this funny trembling of some details. I'll zoom in here, so it's easier for you to spot this effect too. As you can see, these bits are kind of dancing. We'll call this effect Jitter of Details, or Jitter for short. It kind of looks like you have some heat waves visible in the footage, but in fact has nothing to do with hot air. Jitter of Details is usually caused by aggressive video codecs, and again, Neat Video has a tool to deal with it. When you spot something similar happening in your video, try adjusting Jitter of Details. It's also worth checking this box to see if it gives you a better result. As usual, don't go overboard with it. This looks good. I think the result is solid. I'll set an area inside this window to see before and after. What a difference! This picture looks like it was taken by a different camera. Now, let's switch between the two variants and check the difference between them too. Just to remind you, variant number 1 is based on a profile built on one of the frames of this video, and it doesn't have any filter adjustments. Variant number 2 is based off generic profile, which was adjusted to suit this particular video. I also adjusted noise level, local flicker, radius, and jitter of details, as this video has not only noise, but also other issues. And as you can see, the result is speaking for itself. That's all, guys. Give a thumbs up if you like this tutorial, and remember to download the clip I was using and noise profile with the filter settings from the link in the description. Follow me through all the steps, and you will learn how to get impressive results, even with a video that suffers from heavy noise and aggressive compression. Get better at denoising. If you have any comments or questions, please let us know. We will be happy to help. And bye for now.